Today, guys, we're painting all the seats in the Prelude.
Spent the better part of the day uninstalling all of the seats, the carpet for the trunk, and just all the fabric. Kind of decided I wasn't going to waste your guys' time in all the prep work and vacuuming all this stuff down and getting it cleaned up. I also went ahead and painted all of the plastic trim that is just on the various panels here on the seats. All that is left is to do the actual material, the fabric material itself. Just also picked up 3 cans of the Dupli-Color dye. I have 1 can that is like 3/4 full, maybe half full, so that should hopefully get us through all of this material.
We're just gonna jump into it. I already did all the prep work, so I'm just gonna go ahead and switch over to GoPro and just start painting all of these seats.
Just finished up the first coat. I went ahead and hit everything with a light coat and then took the nylon brush and pushed all of the bristles on the fabric the opposite direction. And I'm gonna go ahead and hit it with the second coat here soon. I did decide that I'm gonna not hit this piece yet because it's really not crucial and it's gonna take up a lot of paint. I'd rather see these seats get finished.
Just finished up coat number 2. Things are looking a little smoky, a little charcoaly, not nearly black yet.
Overall, it's starting to come together. I used up 1 can and I'm like halfway through one of the new cans. So I have a feeling even what I got today for this isn't gonna be enough, but you know what? It is what it is. I've already started, so there's no going back now. I'm gonna just keep hitting this with coats and I'll catch up with you guys when hopefully a lot of this is quite a bit more black.
Welcome back, guys. Well, not even welcome back. It's been no time at all for you, but for me, it is the next day.
Here is how yesterday's progress came out. Obviously, you can tell they don't even resemble blue anymore, but they're definitely not done yet. Like, there's definitely still some bluish tint coming through that and a little bit of gray now. But overall, this is how it came out. You may notice that the driver's seat is a little bit more done than everything else, and that is because I decided to use my entire last can of paint last night just on this driver's seat to kind of get an idea of what the final product will look like. I still think this seat will need some more paint, but we're getting very close. One thing I still have yet to figure out is how to get these seams. So what I'm thinking is I'm just gonna have to put on some gloves, and as I'm painting this, I'm just gonna have to put pressure down on the seat in different places to try and get in those seams. But otherwise, it's looking good. I mean, that was 1 extra can. This was obviously 1 less can, but it's getting there, guys. Went and ran to Advanced Auto Parts real quick and got 5 more cans of this. So I'm hoping that should be enough to finish this project and at least get all the seats and everything done and put back into the car.
Fam, we got 1 can of paint left and this is how everything is coming out. I can't even tell you how many coats I'm in. I'm easily like 7 cans of paint in, and I think that will be can number 8. You can definitely still see the imperfections, like where all the suede has rubbed off, but I mean, I wasn't planning on restoring these seats, simply changing the color, so I'm fine with that. They were already like that and already old, so just having them black is already an upgrade. I would say everything has come out like pretty even as far as how the coats of paint have laid down, and I haven't really noticed any tiger striping or anything like that, but I think that's because it's fabric, it's fibrous. And one key point on this, when you guys are doing this, it's very crucial to grab a nylon bristled brush, and while the paint is wet, key, while the paint is wet, you want to go ahead and wipe the paint in different directions with the bristle brush. I basically have had way better luck with that and getting more coverage, because before, when I was just spraying it and leaving it, I would come back and bristle it and it would be like I almost didn't even spray it. So you really have to do it while the paint is wet. So I wouldn't recommend spraying everything and then going back around to do it. You wanna spray a piece, wipe it, spray a piece, wipe it, spray a piece, wipe it, etc. So that's been my process, guys. Outside of that, really just vacuuming the seats initially. And I've been using this Dupli-Color vinyl and fabric paint. So been having good luck with it. I'm gonna go ahead and hit them with this last coat of paint and show you guys the final product.
Ooh yeah, buddy. How about that? The interior is all complete. This is how it came out. I'm pretty happy with it. It took me about 8 or 9 cans of spray paint. I did go ahead and start putting the seats back together. So little plastic levers and whatnot, and the stickers that go on there, the emergency release. But overall, really happy with it. Kept the buttons still red. Was able to get these stickers back on. I might need to go back with a little more adhesive there, but you guys get the picture. Overall, definitely not blue anymore. And I'm excited to get this all put back into the Prelude and see what it looks like, because I think when it's all in there and because of the tint and everything else being black, it's going to make these look a lot darker and a lot more better. Yes.
I'm going to go ahead and skip putting it all back in. It's really just like 8 or so bolts and screws. It's really not a lot to get all these seats and everything back into the car. So I'll catch you guys when everything is back in the Prelude and show you guys what the final result looks like.
Well guys, after 2 very long days, the interior, well the seats I should say, are finally complete and they look pretty dang good. I'm just impressed with this paint yet again. To be honest, it's just so versatile for the interior of a car. I mean, I've used it on everything from all sorts of different types of plastic to now this fabric and eventually the carpets underneath here. But overall, guys, I'm really happy with it. Again, can't really do much about this. This is just worn out. It was gonna be like that regardless, but I would say I'd give this paint like an 8 out of 10 on these seats. One thing that was pretty difficult though was getting in these seams and stuff, but I think I did a pretty good job. I mean, even if I just tried sitting in them and it's not enough compression to actually, you know, push those seams apart enough to even see the blue that does still exist. So I'm really happy with it. The back seat looks really good. Still gotta do these seat belts and those seat belts, but outside of that, the back is all black and it's getting hard to film in here.
So guys, with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. It's just a lot of painting on this thing. And like I said, I wanted to keep you guys involved on the process. So now we've gotten a bunch of the plastic done. We've gotten the headliner done. We've gotten the back area wrapped in suede. And now we've gotten the seats done. So all that is really left is the door cards, these upper pillars here, and the dash, and the carpet too. So definitely still a lot more to go, but we're getting there. It's slowly but surely going from blue to black, guys. So I appreciate you guys for sticking around for these episodes and putting up with just endless amounts of painting, but you gotta do what you gotta do. So if you enjoyed this one, give it a thumbs up. Comments down below if you have any suggestions, ways I could have improved this method. But outside of that, guys, hit that sub button if you're new, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Keep elevating. Adios.